But now, Mark, Addy is putting his hat firmly back on in his latest role. He's here to tell us more in 10 minutes' time. Good morning. Now, he burst onto our screens in the British smash hit film The Full Monty. He's taken on Hollywood and now he's starring in a very British comedy. Here's Mark Addy in action.
Oh, hello, Julie.
Oh, you can tell boss woman a plan's not going to work. She won't force me out.
What?
This new Andy, it won't work.
I've got absolutely no idea what you're talking about.
Oh, sorry, I thought she'd be keeping you in the loop. I guess we're both out in the cold.
For your information, I'm a very valued member of the management team.
I bet she didn't tell you about the pool table either, did she?
Not that it's any of your business, Andy, but I'm on a need-to-know executive managerial synergy. Explain myself to underlings.
Mark's here now, away from your butcher counter.
That's right.
I'm playing alongside some great people in this series. Jane Horrocks.
Yeah,
is your manager.
Jane Horrocks is my manager and nemesis. We rub it up against each other quite a lot, Jane and I, in this one, because she's one of those kind of pompous British characters who needs their bubble bursting, basically. And Andy does that on a regular basis.
Well, he's not a fan, is he?
No, not really.
And you've got another kind of matriarchal figure coming into the cast this year in the form of Stephanie Beecham.
That's right.
From the Colbys and Dynasty to Trollied.
Yeah. She's gone a different direction this time. It's great. I mean, she plays a terrific character, Lorraine Chain, who comes in with new ideas about how this supermarket should be run.
And that is the whole premise of the series. It's about the goings-on of the staff that work at this big supermarket based in Warrington, is that right?
That's right, yeah. We're in Valco, in the Warrington branch, which is, you know, a kind of a supermarket chain that are not in the big league, but, they're doing quite well. But it's really just the kind of mundane lives of the people that work there. You never see outside the workplace. You hear a little bit about their lives just through the dialogue. But I think it's the mundanity of it that appeals to me, because I think, you know, most people live their lives in that sort of way.
Yeah, they do, absolutely. Now, this is going out on Sky One.
Sky One, 9 o'clock tonight.
And quite a departure in terms of the roles that we know you for. Going right back to the beginning, obviously The Full Monty, where we saw quite a lot of you.
Yes, too much, people would argue.
Well, look, before we talk about that, let's take a look. It was a blockbuster of a movie, and here's why.
I'd like to apologise to the people who are still eating their breakfast at this time, because that's not what you need to see this time.
When
anymore.
That clip came on, you went, oh.
Oh, no. I used to have hair back in those days.
And that film just meant so much to the British film industry, to the people that went out, and there are millions to go and watch it. What do you think it was about it that resonated so much, that kind of touched a nerve?
I don't know. Again, I think it was possibly the fact that the guys involved looked like regular, normal blokes. All due respect to the rest of the boys, nobody's looks like a movie star in there. And I think people found that refreshing.
But you did become, all of you, you know, huge movie stars, nominated for awards all over the world. And in fact, you know, it saw you take off to Hollywood and try your hand over there, and you didn't really like it, did you?
It's all right. It's not. I never felt at home there. It's a very strange place, Los Angeles. But you get used to the way that it works. And as long as you are aware that it's not real, then you're fine.
What were the things that kind of that didn't sit well with you about the place? Because you're right, it exists on a kind of a set of rules all of its own.
Well, yeah, and nobody should really be living there. You're on a major fault line. There's earthquakes, there's mudslides. It's insane.
Everyone's an actor.
Everyone is an actor or a scriptwriter or
a producer.
Yeah, that's the taxi driver. They've script for you. Really? It's tricky. Yeah, people who you wouldn't think could string a sentence together have a script I like. Very good. I'll take a read of that.
Did you make any friends over there? Because there's a huge expat community over there, isn't there?
There is, yeah, yeah. And, you know, you tend to gravitate towards people with which you have something in common. So, yeah, there are a lot of expats there.
And then, of course, the people that you work with, you work with Paul Bettany, fellow Brit.
Yeah, yeah.
Heath Ledger, the late Heath Ledger.
Yeah, yeah.
And then, of course, you know, Game of Thrones, which was a big series to come out of there. When you went up for roles like that, were you ever expecting to get down to winning the role?
No, I mean, you know, with Game of Thrones, I knew it was a fantastic part and one that I'd love to do. But it's convincing.
You said you used to have hair back then. Look at the hair you got there.
Oh, there's plenty of hair there. Oh, if only. But no, you know, that was terrific in that, you know, it showed... Americans used to seeing me doing comedy. I did a sitcom out there for 4 years. So to see me do something a little bit more serious...
Yeah, it's great.
Is, you know, it's terrific.
And again, trollied something entirely different as well.
But I'm king of the meat counter. That's the main thing.
Well, good luck with the series, and thank you for getting out of your bed and coming in and talk to us
That's
today.
Quite all right.
Thanks, Mark. OK.